Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular 0 to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about the lifecycle hooks in Angular. And in this video, I'm going to explain about routing. Routing means navigation between pages. Navigation is one of the important aspects in a web application. Even though a single page application does not have multiple page concept, it does move from one view to another view. So routing is an important concept in Angular. And the Angular router is a core part of the Angular platform. It enables developers to build single page applications with multiple views and allow navigation between these views. Using a simple example, we can see how we can use routing in our application. To explain the other basic concepts, so far I have mostly created applications without router module. But now I'm going to make use of Angular CLI to create an application with router module. So when we choose yes to this question, the CLI will create an application with router module. We can see a new file, app routing module, is created. And also in root module, we can see this app routing module is configured. If you have created an application without choosing this option, and if you like to add the routing module, you can simply create the app routing module file and configure that in root module. It will work. Okay, let me create few components. Now we have four new components. In app component, let me delete the existing code and add home component alone. Let me change the content and add some styles so that we can see the component clearly. Let me quickly format the other components also. You can see the URL is now localhost colon 4200 and we are seeing contents from home component. That is because we have configured in root component like that. But when I navigate to localhost colon 4200/about, I should see the about component. And when I navigate to localhost colon 4200/products, I should see the product component. We can use the routing module to achieve that functionality. In routing module, we can see a constant of type routes from angular/router. Through these routes, we need to inform Angular about which component should be loaded when we hit a path in URL. Routes is an array in which we can pass a JavaScript object. In this JavaScript object, we can specify the key as path. Let me give the value as home. So now I need to inform what should Angular do when it meets the path home. Let me ask to load home component. So for that, I can use another key component and mention home component there. One thing to note here is path value is a string and home component is a component. And so we need to import that. Let me also create the other routes quickly. Now the routes are ready and so we need to register the routes with the router module through for route method. But we can see it is already registered. CLI has registered that for us. Now Angular knows which component it needs to load when a path is matched. But we haven't informed Angular yet where the component has to be loaded. We can inform that using router outlet directive. So in app component, let me delete the hardcoded home component and I am using a router outlet directive. Now if we enter localhost colon 4200/home, we can see the home page, and if we enter localhost colon 4200/about, we can see the about page. So our routing is working. But if you see, when the server is started, the URL will be just localhost colon 4200. There will not be any path added. So we can also inform Angular what we need to do when there is no path. So let me add an empty path route. Now this is good. Now we know how to configure route. Let's try to use this in a navigation. I am going to create a header and add some navigation links there. Let me configure the routes in the respective hrefs. Now we can see the routing is working, but this is wrong because we are refreshing the page every time. You can see that in the console. Every time when I hit an URL, the application is loading again. You can also see that in the browser tab. So how can we fix that? Angular is providing another directive to resolve this. We should not use href. Instead, we can use routerLink directive. When I replace, we can see it is still working, but the application is not reloading this time. This is the right way. Also, Angular provides us another directive to highlight the active route, that is routerLinkActive. We can specify a CSS class on that and apply some style. So when that route is matched, it will be highlighted. But we have a problem here. When we move to home route, it works. But when I refresh it, in other words, when the page is loaded, it will not highlight the home route because here we have an empty route only. So it won't match. We can fix it in a different way. Let me explain one option. In routing module, instead of specifying the component for empty route, we can use another option, redirect to. In redirect to, we can specify the path to which it needs to be redirected. But when we use redirect to for empty route, we need to specify path match also. When I add that and refresh, we can see the page is redirected to home, and so home is highlighted. So now I hope you understand how you can configure route and use routerLink directive to navigate to other pages. But these routes are configured in the template, and so when you click that, it will take you to the page immediately. But assume you need to do something before moving to the new page. For example, assume you need to update in database and after successful update, you need to go to the new page. How can we do that? There is another way of routing. It is called routing programmatically. Let me create a button in home component and call a function. Now inside this function, I can have a call to DB to update something. But now let me put a console to mock that up. And after it is updated, we need to route to products page. So to do that, we need to get access to the router. Let me inject that in the constructor. Now I can use the navigate function in the router to route the user to products page. Let's preview this. We can see when I click the button, it say it is trying to update the database. And then it say database is updated. In the meantime, after it is updated, it is also routed to products page. Let me show that again. Okay. And what will happen when we enter any other URL other than the path we have mentioned in the routes? Actually, it will error out. Let me show that. When I enter something, it says cannot match any routes. But we have an option to handle this. We can have a wildcard route using 2 stars, and we can route it to an error component or page not found component to show a general error page. For now, let me redirect to home. So when I enter something, it will redirect to home. One thing to note here is, if we are having a wildcard route, that should be our last route. Otherwise, whatever routes present below will be ignored. Let me show that. When I refresh, we can see we are in home. And we can go to about, but when I click contacts, it will be redirected to home. Same thing for products. So this is important. Next, let me explain how we can pass a parameter through route. Let me add some products in the products page. And when this product is clicked, we need to show the respective product page. So to achieve this, let me create a product page. and configure the routes. Now we can see when I click, it will route it to the respective pages. But I need to get the respective product, and also if the product count is big, I need to add routes for each product. That is not right. But in Angular, we can have a route like this. After changing this, we can see our routes are working. But how can we get this parameter in product component? Let me show you that. In product component, let me create a variable and show it in the template. Now I need to get the name from the route and show it in the component. For that, I need to access the current route. I can access it using activated route. Let me inject that. Now in ng on init, I can get the params using route.snapshot.params like this. Now we can see we are able to show the product name in each page. I believe I have explained all the basics in routing, but routing is a big topic. We still have so many concepts like child routes, relative and absolute path, query params, fragments, subscribing to router events, route guards, etc. I will explain all these concepts in the advanced course, which is coming up soon. And routing is an important topic because we use routing in almost all applications. So practice well. I have also uploaded this code in GitHub repo. You can get it using this link. I have provided the link in description also. And next, I'm going to explain about how we can create and use forms in Angular. So many things are coming up. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.